everyone. A lot of people ask me for Segula le parnassa, a way to have more income, to open our mazal, and to get more parnassa, more blessed money. So one of the things that we can do, that it's actually brought down in the holy book of Zohar and also in the Talmud, is being careful in the mitzvah of netilat yadaim. Netilat yadaim is washing our hands before we eat bread, before we eat a meal. And it says in the Talmud that Rav Chisda, one of the big rabbis of the Talmud, he was very careful in this mitzvah. He was using a lot of water to make sure that the water covers all the hand. He was using a lot of water to do netilat yadaim. And he says, because I was very careful to use a lot of water to cover all the hand and being careful doing this mitzvah of netilat yadaim, Kadosh Baruch Hu Hashem gave me tivuta. He gave me a lot of blessing, and Baruch Hashem, he had a lot of income because of that mitzvah. And this is the first place when actually the Torah reveals the secret of the connection between doing netilat yadayim with a lot of water and being careful in this mitzvah and having more blessing in our income. So this is one place when we see it. There's another place brought down in the Zohar HaKadosh, the holy book of Zohar, Kabbalah. Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, he had a son, his name was Rabbi Eliezer, Rabbi Elazar. They both were in the cave learning Torah and writing the book of Zohar, as we know. One time, Rabbi Elazar, the son of Rabbi Shimon, he met another Talmid Chacham, another smart person, the learning Torah. His name was Yoezer. This Yoezer, he was very smart. He was very, he was a special person. However, he was very poor. He didn't have money almost to eat. And when Rabbi Elazar saw him, they were talking, and Rabbi Yoezer so told him, listen, you know, my situation, I don't have blessing in parnassa and income. So he told him, listen, your case, I think you need a blessing from my father, Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. Come to the Bet Midrash, come to the synagogue, he's learning now, and maybe you will get a blessing. They approached Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai, and Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai told him, I want to tell you a big, big secret. Netilat yadayim, when you do it with a lot of water, it gives you a lot of blessing up in heaven. However, this mitzvah, when you're very careful in it, it also gives you a lot of blessing here in this physical world. So that's why if you will be careful doing the mitzvah with a lot of water, even though it costs you more money because there's a certain situation that you don't have enough water, you have to buy water, do whatever you can to do that mitzvah with a lot of water, cover all the hand up until here, and you will have a blessing. And this is what happened. He started to do that when Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai saw that he took his word seriously and started to do this. Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai was talking to God, to Hashem, and says, Ribono shel olam, male yadav mi berchotecha. Please open all the pipes and give him a full blessing in income. And this is what happened. This person became very rich, and Baruch Hashem, he opened a lot of food banks and other stuff, was helping people. This is all because he was starting being careful to do netilat yadayim, washing his hands before eating with a lot of water. So the mefarshim, the rabbis that explain the Zohar and the Talmud, says that there's few conditions to this segula. One of the conditions is we have to do it all the time. There's people that they do netilat yadayim, they do it properly, but not all the time. When it's very hard, when they are in a rush, when there's no enough water, they do half. They don't do it the proper way. They don't do it like it should be. He says the segula, this blessing works when a person accepts it upon himself as something for all life. I'm going to be careful doing netilat yadayim all the time with a lot of water and covering all the hand, making sure that everything is wet. And this mitzvah will, Bezrat Hashem, guarantee a blessing in income in parnassa. This is a big secret of the Zohar HaKadosh that he tells us. There's There's one book called Mateh Ha'aron. This book says that a person has to be careful in netilat yadaim even when it's cost him a lot of money. So for example, when you go to a picnic or something outside, you don't have water right now. Go and buy water, even though in the gas station they sell water for very expensive. You know, it's not like $1. It's sometimes more than that. And you have to have a lot of water for your hand, for three times in this hand and three times in that hand. And sometimes it will cost you more money, will take you more time. You have to be careful to get a vessel, yeah, a good vessel that you can wash hands, because it's only with a vessel. You cannot just wash hands in the sink, right? So you have to make an effort, even though it's hard, even though it costs you money. When you put all your effort to do this mitzvah properly, the Zohar Kadosh, the Talmud, guarantees that person the blessing to come to him, and Bezrat Hashem will have a lot of blessing and parnasa. I wish all of us, Bezrat Hashem, Yiratzon, because of this mitzvah of Natilat Yadayim, to get a big blessing from Hashem. And we have to remember that one of the Rabbanim say, we should do it not because it gives us money. We should do it because I want to be careful in this mitzvah. I understand the importance. If HaKadosh Baruch Hu give us a reward in heaven and also here in this world for that mitzvah, that means that this mitzvah is very important. And that's what I do it, because I care about the mitzvah, not just because I want to have money. If we have that intention, that's even better. Bezrat Hashem, to get a big blessing. Amen and amen.